Okay, so what were the big ideas of this lesson? Well, one idea is that good algorithms are work optimal and have low span. Imagine that a DAG is a person where dependencies go from head to toe. Now, a good algorithm is a person who has low mass and is short and really wide, rather than being, say, really massive, super tall, and super skinny. Now, a related idea is the concept of weak scalability. To see if you understand this concept, here's an exercise. Go and read about this thing called Amdahl's law, which you might already know from a different Udacity course. Then ask yourself, self, what's the relationship between Amdahl's law and this weak scalability concept? A second big idea in this lesson is divide and conquer, which you know and love from sequential computing, and it's an excellent tool and paradigm for thinking about parallel algorithms as well. Now, in your toolbox of algorithmic tricks, it should often be the first thing you try. The last big idea is to separate how you express concurrency from how you execute it. Now, this is a really neat idea, which makes it possible to get truly elegant algorithms. Unfortunately, this model also ignores communication, which it turns out is absolutely necessary to be fast and scalable, at least once the problem size and the system size get big enough. To model communication, you're going to need some other abstract models. But for now, let's just see how far we can take dynamic multithreading.